There had to be an elevator sitting right in here somewhere.
Right here?
Right in here somewhere, I would say.
One of those four that are in that picture, huh?
Yeah.
Now, one time there was four, and then you thought one of these two that are sitting up here sat down further, right?
This one here, the one on the north side, sat down this way farther.
Okay.
Yeah, there had to be one here, or somewhere like that, because there were two here.
And then over here...
Oh, we got someone behind us, all kinds of people.
That is to say, two cars.
Yeah. Well, you're oil king.
Just the man I wanted to see.
Gotta go open the cafe for a can of half and half for this guy.
Oil king.
Here's the basketball courts they built where there used to be Roostein's Rec. Recreation, that is. This is a local Peaver historian here.
Yeah.
We're going to take a little drive around town.
I'm, let's see, who's older me? Roy's older me. And his mother, of course. She's 102 or 3. Okay, there's those elevators.
Okay.
The north one is the one that comes from Keller.
Oh, that came from Keller originally, which was a town north of here, right?
Yeah.
Out in the slough?
Yeah, about 2 miles north.
Two north, okay. Yeah,
they're kind of leaning on one another.
Yeah.
That way they ain't going no place.
How would they have moved that?
They moved them with horses and what you call a deal that it wound the cable around the pulley or something somehow.
Uh-huh.
Feel that?
Yeah, I think you got a lump on the tire or something.
Well, how come it don't do it when I do driving two wheel?
I don't know.
Okay, and the other elevator, one set right here.
Yeah.
There had to be one down here at one time. They must move them two together.
Okay, because was there two sitting right here when this burnt?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have room now.
1950, you helped build that, huh? And then these were just old, like, railroad storage buildings?
Well, that was a corn crib at one time. They put ear corn in there.
In this end one here?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then they put, boarded her up and tinned her up and put grain in it for a long time.
Okay, and now it's just used for, like,
lumber. Now it's just falling apart.
Now it's just falling apart.
Yeah.
Okay, can we get through here? This doesn't look real...
Look
like the road... the most traveled here.
No, I don't.
Can you sneak right through there?
This little building here withstood both of those fires when that elevator burnt in 1949, this one here.
Uh-huh.
And then it withstood this one too.
And this one was in about 1980 something, right?
Yeah. Yard was C.E. McGowan.
Who? C.E. who?
McGowan.
He was the original?
They owned the elevator, lumber yards in Wilmot, Ortonville, Millbank, Peaver System.
Did Kenny Vig buy it from them?
First Victoria Elevator Company bought it, and then Kenny ended up with it.
Mm.
Right in here is where Bob Kruger's house sat, and then Ella sat right over here.
Ella.
That one over there. That house over here set right here.
This, okay,
hold on.
Ella Pond's house.
Yeah.
Why did they move it over here?
Well, Pat had those lots.
Oh, okay. I think you better put her in four-wheel drive. I guess we won't go through there. It's about 3 feet deep. Oh, now you're backed into a snowbank here. Whose house was this originally?
Joe Steffler.
Joe Steffler. And what did he do?
He was kind of a jack of all trades. You name it, he was doing it. He was selling farm machinery, sold real estate.
Okay, he must have done okay for himself,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. You say Louis?
Louis German.
Louis
Landmarks.
German. Landmarks.
And Troy Foster.
Troy. And then who originally lived in this house?
Well, when I first knew it, it was a GTA elevator up here. It was there where their managers lived.
Okay, the GTA elevator.
The first one that I know living here was Darrington.
Okay.
And then it was Peterson.
Okay.
Then Elshog.
Oh, Reuben lived there?
Reuben Elshog.
Reuben Elshog lived there.
And Wayne Warner.
And Wayne, yeah. And Wayne is the first one I remember. It actually looks very nice now, don't it? Matt had a flat roof up there one time.
Yeah. Val lived there.
Okay, now looking down this street.
This is where the Catholic Church was, right directly, right in front of us.
That would have been right there in front
where
of us.
Where that snow pile is.
Okay. And this is where we think that big White House would have been, huh, where Harold's is?
I think it would have been right in here.
Somewhere in here, yeah.
But there was a pond house that used to be here. That was a big, low style house.
Mm. And then this is the Banker Rice.
Right over there.
Over here.
Right over there is where that sat. Right in there.
Yeah. And that was probably the nicest house in town.
Well, that's out in the country.
Or in the country.
Yeah. This is in town, but that's in the country.
Oh, okay.
That right where the trees end, that's the end of the city.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Huh. And this land out in here is all plotted for Peaver.
Plenty of room to grow.
Yeah, it's all plotted, but I own it now.
So if anyone's looking for lots, call.
Yeah.
Call Al.
Right. Along the fence down, way down there somewhere, the slaughterhouse used to be. There was a spring that ran.
Yeah.
And they'd go down there and butcher animals and wash them off and all that good stuff. It was a Peaver slaughterhouse.
Really?
And I remember when we first moved here, I could see that little building sitting out there, and I often wondered what it was.
And that was just something that the community kind of used, or was it a business?
Well, I don't know whether J.F. Fredericks put it there or who did, but it was there.
Okay.
And someday I'm going to go down there with some kind of a, see if I can find that spring or whatever it was.
It was just like a flowing spring?
It had to have been, yeah.
Huh. And then this would be the pond place over here, right?
Right. That's just that right over here. That building right there, right over where that brick wood is.
Okay, yeah. I think that's Lance and Sharon's old trailer there when they first got married.
Yeah.
Okay, so now pull ahead a little. On this corner here was the pond dairy.
Yeah.
And that would have been relatives of Pat. His folks, and they bottled milk.
Yeah, the foundation was right in there.
And peddled milk around town.
Right.
Huh? Were they like the main suppliers of milk
in
this part of town? What year would that have been?
In the 1940s.
In the 40s. Okay, interesting.
Where that house sits, that's Wayne Horner's house. Violet Carr built it.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
That's where the old first original Peaver school stood.
Right there?
Right there.
Was that just like a one-room schoolhouse then?
Sort of, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Huh. And then this is Edine and Ellie's house here, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And then is
his dad's house is right behind.
That would have been Elf?
Elf Landmark, yeah.
The little house there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know if he built it or not, but he probably did.
I remember him living there. His birthday was on February 29th, right?
Yep. I mean, every 4 years he had a birthday.
Yeah. Now, is this the old Anton Platten house here?
Yeah.
Who else would have lived there besides him?
Well, when I moved here in 44, that house sat a quarter of a mile east of town here.
Oh, okay.
And he originally it sat about where it's sitting now.
Oh, you mean
and they moved it out there, and when Anton bought it, he moved it back basically just about to the same spot that it was in before.
Huh. So that's a early version of a mobile home.
Yeah.